on the demand of one of my friend on YouTube, I'm creating this video. The topic that he gave me was phrasal verb. So we are going to deal with the series of videos which will be about the phrasal verb. Alongside, I'll be creating the subject matter for the students of ICSE 10th standard, like how to deal with the other elementary parts of the grammar. That would be different stuff. And alongside, we'll be dealing with the phrasal verb. Okay, so let's talk about, first of all, what are exactly the phrasal verb. Okay, phrasal verb, first of all, is a combination of two words. One is phrasal, another is verb. So from that, we can conclude that it is a combination of, let us say, phrasal plus verb. Okay. But why we call it a phrasal verb? Because it comes in the form of the group of words which does not have the complete meaning until or unless we use them in a complete sentence. Okay, that is actually the basic meaning of the phrasal verb. But now what we're gonna do is we'll be using that board, and I'll be discussing about what are different kinds of the phrasal verb and how we need to deal with all of them. So stay tuned. Now, dealing with the concept of the phrasal verb, we know that it is a combination of two words. One is phrasal, another is verb. Okay, why we call it a phrasal verb? Suppose we say came into. Okay, this is a phrasal verb. Why it is a phrasal verb? It is a combination of one and the two words. And when there is a combination of two words and it does not have the complete meaning, we call it a phrase. And basically, if the head word is the verb, then definitely it would be a phrasal verb. If the head word is the verb, then definitely it is a phrasal verb. But rest of the part, like whatever is there along with the verb, if it is given there, we know that it is a preposition. It can be an adverb also. Okay. Depending upon the use of the word, we can call it a preposition or adverb. We all know that. Okay, if it can be adverb or a preposition, but altogether we call it particle. Okay, when we create a phrasal verb, when we use a phrasal verb in a sentence, we intentionally won't know that, like, we are using the combination of this or that. But in case somebody is asking you that what is that all combination all about, you can say that it is a combination of verb plus particle. Okay, the verb and the particle. Okay, now came is a verb, we know that. Came or into, we can use come into also. Depending upon the kind of tense we are using, we can use it accordingly. Okay, and then after this one, let me just erase this. Okay, firstly, what we did is, like, it is a combination of particle and the verb. Verb plus particle is a phrasal verb. Like, I gave you example, came into. Okay, so that's one example. There are number of numerous example, turn on, turn off, something like that. Okay, the combination of verb plus a preposition or an adverb altogether, like, can be called as verb and particle. Okay, particle can be of two categories: preposition or adverb. I'm repeating so that you will remember it. Okay, so preposition and adverb can be the particle. Now it comes the turn of like, what are the different categories of the phrasal verb and how can we remember them? Okay, there are four categories that you can remember. Actually, there are two categories. Then those categories are divided into further two categories. But basically, we can divide them in four categories so that we can remember them separately. Okay, first category is that one. Like, the way we know that verbs are of two categories. Action verbs usually used to be of two categories: transitive, okay, and intransitive. The way action verb can be a transitive verb, can be intransitive, same way phrasal verb can also be a transitive verb or intransitive verb. And based upon the fact, like, that these are for, they have further two categories and one has only one category, we have two other categories. I'm writing these two categories separately here. Separable separable, inseparable. Inseparable. One can be a separable phrasal verb and can be inseparable. I told you, we know that first of all we should know that what is a transitive phrasal verb. Based upon the same notion like how the action verb is divided, we know that the transitive verb used to be of like an object, used to carry one object at last. Can be direct object, can be indirect object. Okay. That is a separate case. We can have the direct object or the indirect object. Then the verb is going to be called as transitive verb. That means the action is getting transferred to the other one. Like that would be the transitive phrasal verb. Intransitive would be the one when the action is not getting transferred. There is no object given. That means when the action is missing, simply we are using a complement or something to make the verb meaningful. Simply it has a meaning. That means it gets a complete meaning, but the thing is there is no object at last. Okay, like suppose I say I kill or I killed him. Okay, in one sentence I have the object, in one sentence I don't have, but here I am using action verb. Okay, or I say I turned into or I change into a bird or something like that. He changed into a bird. We say he changed into a bird. He changed into a bird. Okay. Like that. If the combination is like here, we are not talking about the combination. I'm just trying to tell you that there is object or not. If the object is present, then it is the transitive phrasal verb. If the object is not present, then it is the intransitive phrasal verb. But based upon the fact and the notion, I mentioned that the transitive verb can be of two categories. One is separable, another is inseparable. Okay. But here, when we talk about intransitive, it can be only inseparable. That means words like that, these two words, whatever we use, cannot be separated by any means. Like we can't separate, like suppose there is came into. We can't separate these two words in case it is used in intransitive place. Like when it is used as an intransitive verb. And there is no notion, there is no rule which is mentioned to tell that whether the like how to identify where to use separable or inseparable. Okay. So it depends upon our use, like the way we use it. But it is clear when it is to be used, like when there is object, it can be used in either way, separable or inseparable. But in intransitive case, it will always be inseparable. These two words can never be separated, always will come together. Came into will come together, cannot be came came him or something like object is not there, so came into. Okay. I came into the class. That is a different case. Okay, let me just use a suitable example. He picked up the pencil. Now here the object is present. Okay, that is why here it can be used like as inseparable. He picked the pencil up can also be used because it is possible in both the cases. Okay, separable, we separated picked and up, separated because there was a presence of a noun or can be a pronoun, like can be a pronoun form. But if those are present, then it is possible that we can use it in both the ways. Otherwise, inseparable, whenever we are using it at the last only and there is no other thing added to that except the complement. Okay, like he jumped into
furiously or the way it is done, like, but here there is no object present, it is used together, okay, so we can't separate them in such a case. We can't say he jumped furiously into, so the meaning would be different, okay. So that's one of the example. Now I hope that this video must have given you some information about the phrasal verb. That phrasal verb, first of all, what are those? That's a combination of a preposition and the particle, and particle can be of two kinds. One can be a preposition, other can be an adverb, okay. And then there are four categories of the phrasal verb. One is a transitive phrasal verb, other is intransitive, and then is separable and inseparable. These two actually are the subcategories of these two only. Intransitive verb can never be separable, okay. It will always be coming together whenever we are using it in the without any object, then definitely we'll be using the phrasal verb always together. It cannot be separated. But in case we are using it in case of the object present in the sentence, then definitely it will be used. It can be used as separably and inseparable, both ways. So I hope so that this video must have been helpful to you to understand the basics of the phrasal verb. In the next video, we're going to talk about the meaning of some of the phrasal verbs, which are very much important for the exams of all kinds, as well as their meaning. And we'll be choosing one alphabet and we'll be doing it. Okay. Alongside, I'm going to start one crash course for learning the ingredients of IELTS, and as well as what are the different strategies that you can use to score in different parts of the IELTS, like all those modules, listening, reading, writing and speaking. If you are really interested to join in, I'll be sharing the link for the same with you, and I'll be just updating that one, like whatever number you're going to share with me, then I'll be having a group, and in that group we'll be having one whole class into that, and then thereafter I'll be sharing the Zoom link, all will be there, and then we're gonna start a class and we're gonna study. Thank you very much for joining in, and share my video with your friends and allies, and subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon to get updates of the new videos. Thank you. Bye bye. Take care.